Looking at a set of control arms for your muscle car? Yeah, they look great, but there's more to it than that. We're going to talk today about the geometry that goes into these control arms. Hi, I'm Steve at QA1. I'm here with Damien Braze, our fitment technician, talking about our control arms here and the benefits of going to a tubular control arm. One of the features that we add into this control arm as far as the enhancement to the geometry is what, Damien?
So, biggest thing is we're going to add some caster to these. We split the caster between the upper and lower control arms. That's going to help keep the wheel centered in the wheel well. And the added caster is one of the biggest things that you're going to notice driving a car down the road. 60s cars, generally, they're going to have zero or even negative caster, which is going to make the car really easy to turn in a parking lot. But going down the road, it's going to need constant correction to the steering wheel to keep you going straight. By adding caster, positive caster, to the front suspension, that's going to help the car track straighter. It's going to help the steering wheel return to center and keep you going straight going down the road.
And the caster is just one of the geometry benefits that we add to these arms. Let's talk about some of the other benefits, like the camber adjustments.
So we've adjusted the length on the control arms a little bit to help with camber gain. The biggest factor in camber gain is where the control arms are actually mounted on the frame, and it's kind of hard to change that with a set of bolt-on parts. Yeah. So by changing the length, it does affect it a little bit, but having more negative camber is going to help keep the contact patch of the tire flat when you're going around the corner and you get a little bit of body roll. So with the original suspension, these cars generally have a positive camber curve. You go into a corner, the outside tire is going to tip out at the top, which means you're losing contact patch on the ground. So by having a negative camber curve, keeping that contact patch flat on the ground and as much tire in contact with the ground as possible, that's where you're going to get the most cornering grip.
So we've got our caster and camber benefits. Let's talk about the bushings. Bushings do come in these arms. Tell us more about that.
So bushings and ball joints are installed. We did go with harder, either polyurethane or UMHW on the bushing material. So it's a firmer material than the factory rubber bushings. It's minimizing compliance, and it's going to help keep the control arm geometry where it needs to be, especially if you've got, you know, worn out control arm bushings that are maybe original. On a 50, 55-year-old car, that rubber is going to have a lot of room to play and move around. So the harder bushing material is really going to help keep the alignment where it should be.
Yeah, and thinking about the older control arms, taking them out, rebuilding them, putting new bushings into those. The arm's, 50 years old now?
Sure.
So, you know, this is a great option for just bolting it right in and also getting those geometry benefits. Well, those are all great geometry changes to the control arms, Damien. I hear this car behind us has our control arms on it, doesn't it?
Got upper and lower control arms, front coilover kit, and a front sway bar on it.
And so that should pretty much change the
car,
huh?
It makes a big difference in the way the car rides.
What would a customer expect to feel driving a car with the control arms on it?
Car drives down the road straight, like a modern vehicle. Take your hands off the wheel and it keeps going straight.
So, that's a nice feature.
Things that most modern cars have.
I think it's time to go drive it. Yep.
So with most older cars, you're going to have a lot of corrections that you need to put into the steering wheel. You're going to get a lot of this type of stuff. I don't know if it picks up in the video, but as I'm moving the wheel, the car is actually responding. So the added caster has really made a big difference in the way the car drives. I can let go of the steering wheel. We're still going down the road straight. So it really does make the car feel like a more modern car. This GTO drives great. For more information on QA1 products, check out QA1.net or give us a call on the tech line and go drive it.
Roll it. Wondering about the Q... That was a bad start. Not say QA1? Because we work at QA1.
Well, they can see that on our shirts.
Oh, yeah.
And on the stickers. And they'll be on our page, so...